This is dirt from the moon's surface. And on the face of it, it's pretty lifeless. But what if this dirt from the moon or Mars could be used to make rocket fuel on those planets? And could this locally produced rocket fuel be the key to enabling human settlement on Mars? I know this sounds crazy, but hear me out. In order to make traveling to other planets affordable, we need to make rockets reusable. Think of it like an airplane. We don't throw away an airplane after a flight from, say, New York to San Francisco. The good news is that reusable rockets are already a thing. But for a rocket to take off again from another planet, it has to carry its own fuel because we have no way of making fuel on those planets. And this fuel takes up a lot of extra space on the rocket. But what if we could use the dirt on other planets to make rocket fuel locally? Then the rocket wouldn't need to carry all of this extra fuel for the return journey. It can just gas up on Mars before it needs to head back to Earth. And now that the rocket doesn't need all the extra fuel, we have all of the space inside the rocket to carry important supplies with us. Important supplies like communication equipment, construction machines, and farming tools. Equipment that is essential for settling another planet. But is anyone actually working on making rocket gas stations on other planets?
My name is Mihir Gondhalekar. I'm one of the co-founders and the CTO of Starpath Robotics.
Starpath is transforming moon or Mars dirt, technically called regolith, into rocket fuel.
The deeper, you know, mission that we have is to help make life multiplanetary. The real reason we want to do that is to drastically decrease humanity's odds of extinction. And so in order to have enough fuel to get to where the vehicle needs to go and come back, you need a gas station which refuels it locally.
They are solving one of the biggest barriers to making human life possible on other planets. But how do you turn lifeless space dirt into rocket fuel that ultimately enables us to make life multiplanetary? Let's find out. Okay, to understand why Starpath wants to use Moon and Mars dirt, we first need to look at what it is and what it contains. Moon and Mars dirt isn't like the soil here on Earth. It's a regolith, crushed rock created by meteorite impacts over billions of years. And especially on the moon, these particles have razor-sharp edges without wind or water to smooth them. The regolith on these planets contain valuable elements like silicon, iron, and magnesium. But there's one element that has everybody, including Starpath, excited. Water ice. NASA has confirmed ice deposits, especially in PSRs in the lunar South Pole. Can you define PSR?
Yes. PSR is a permanently shattered region. So it is a sort of cratered region on the moon, which never sees sunlight because of the direction or of sunlight hitting the South Pole of the moon is such that if you have a crater, that crater will never see any sun. And it specifically is the regions of the moon which contains water ice.
This isn't just scientifically interesting. Water ice is one of the key ingredients for rocket fuel. So now that we know that Moon and Mars dirt has water in it, why does that matter? Well, we all know the formula for water. It's H2O. It contains two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen bonded together. But when we apply an electric current through a process called electrolysis, something interesting happens to water. The electrical current breaks those tight molecular bonds and splits water into its basic elements, hydrogen and oxygen. So when you take the oxygen that's extracted from water, you can actually cool it down until it becomes a liquid, aka liquid oxygen. Liquid oxygen, or LOX, is a key rocket fuel that's used on vehicles like Starship. The hydrogen isn't useless either. You can actually take the hydrogen and combine it with carbon dioxide in the Martian atmosphere to create methane, which is another important fuel for rockets. Okay, now let's dive into how Starpath actually produces this rocket fuel from dirt on Moon or Mars. Starpath's StarMine system consists of three main components that are used to produce and sell rocket fuel. First, you need a source of power. We need a way to utilize solar energy on Moon or Mars that can power this entire system. So Starpath is building a power tower.
Yes, the power tower, as we call it here. It will hopefully be the largest source of solar energy on the moon. You know, in our ideal version or in our fully formed state, it'll roughly be 40 to 50 meters tall and about 10 to 12 meters wide. It contains six sort of, as we call them, banners or modules of deployable solar panels, which either roll out or Z-fold out into their fully formed state. And it contains a central carbon fiber deployable mast. The carbon fiber mast sort of acts like a tape measure, if you think of it in that manner, where a portion of it unrolls out of the top of its deployer or its rolled state, lifting the power tower up into its full height. Finally, the banners then unfold and drop the solar panels.
Next, you need a way to transport large quantities of raw regolith to a facility where we can extract the water ice. So Starpath is building a fleet of autonomous rovers to do just that. Let's hear from Mihir on how the rover picks up the regolith.
The two mining arms on top of the rover sort of flip down. The mining drums of the rover rotate forward so as to scoop and pick up dust within themselves. There's an internal baffle structure, which makes it such that when the barrels of what we call the ice collection system, or ICS, the mining arms, such that when they're spinning in one direction, they collect dust within themselves, but when they spin the opposite direction, they release the dust. Once the mining barrels dig up the regolith, they flip over, they spin in the opposite direction, and they fill up the, what we call the dump truck, or more scientifically, the regolith tank, which is what you see sitting on the back of the rover there.
So we have a power system that is powering the entire facility. The rover has then collected dirt from a permanently shadowed region of the moon, and it is ready to dump it into the reactor. Let's learn how the reactor actually produces rocket fuel out of space dirt.
Yes, our true moneymaker. So the reactor itself works in kind of a three-part system. The first system of the processing plant is called extraction. The purpose of extraction is to simply take water vapor from the icy regolith, pressurize it, and heat it such that it is liquid water, and feed that liquid water into the second portion of the processing plant, which is the conversion system. The conversion system takes the water, filters it a little bit more, then feeds it into proton exchange membranes, or PEM-style electrolysis. Electrolysis is the act of using energy to split the bond between the hydrogen and oxygen molecules in water. So we use the energy that we're getting from our solar tower, split the water into hydrogen and oxygen, but then we take the oxygen, further separate any water or water vapor that may be present in the oxygen using phase separators, dry the oxygen as much as possible, and then give it to the third portion of the processing plant, which is what we call as the liquefaction portion. Liquefying oxygen on the moon is actually incredibly difficult. And it's sort of unintuitive because you think of the moon as being such a cold place. It must be really easy to cool things off. That's not really the case. While the regolith itself is cold, you don't have any air, you know, to cool components, to sort of reject all of the heat that you've generated. You essentially have to get your dust really hot, and then you have to take what comes out of it and get it really cold. And so liquefaction, as we call it, is its own portion of the system, but is very similar to a sort of a refrigeration cycle. It goes through, you know, a compressor, an expander, and a heat exchanger, and the gaseous oxygen then leaves as liquid oxygen, which is the, you know, the product which we then sell.
We can now make fuel on other planets. But how does this help us make life multiplanetary? Let's return to that original Mars settler scenario. Without Starpath's technology, you'd be leaving behind crucial supplies as you reserve the additional space for the return fuel to bring the rocket back to Earth. But with gas stations and producing fuel locally on other planets, everything changes. When we can refuel rockets using moon and Martian dirt, we unlock exponential cargo capacity on our rockets. This means more building materials, more life support equipment, more scientific instruments, and ultimately, more people can reach Mars safely. By eliminating that need to carry all of that return fuel from Earth, we're eliminating one of the biggest barriers to making life multiplanetary. And gas stations are just one part of that equation. As Mihir puts it, Starpath can produce other critical things needed to make life multiplanetary.
The other thing I do actually want to mention about the processing plant and just about our company as a whole is while we see fuel as being one of the most, you know, critical pieces of, you know, what we produce, especially in order for rockets to get back from Mars, as I described at the beginning, all of the other components that you have to, you know, you sort of create along the way in producing the oxygen are also extremely valuable and needed to help make, you know, or help create a sustained presence on the lunar surface or on Mars. Those components being, you know, the dried out raw regolith, which you can use as sort of building blocks or construction materials. It's essentially just raw material. Another component is the gaseous oxygen, which you create, which humans can then use to breathe. And finally, the water, which the extraction system produces. All of those things, the, you know, the raw materials, the oxygen, the water, the liquid oxygen, all are sort of resources that we seek to produce and produce economically and in vast quantities. We really see Starpath as totally enabling life on the lunar surface and on Mars.
This is exactly why space dirt is the answer to making life multiplanetary. The future of humanity beyond Earth doesn't just depend on bigger rockets. It depends on our ability to live off the land, or rather, live off the regolith wherever we go. Starpath's technology represents that critical shift from one-off missions to permanent settlements on other planets. So next time you look at Mars glowing red in the night sky, remember, they're not just distant worlds anymore. They're also refueling stops on humanity's greatest journey yet.